though. High Chew Candy, I don't know if you guys are familiar with Morinaga's High Chew Candy, but they expanded their flavor selection with the launch of a new kiwi flavor. The new flavor is made with fresh fruit juices and purees for the taste of kiwis, paired with the chewiness that the Moringa High Chew is known for. Chia seeds are incorporated into each candy to mimic the texture and color of actual kiwi seeds. The brand describes the taste of the candy as refreshingly sweet with a hint of citrus, and Morinaga plans to release additional High Chew flavors later this year. High Chew Kiwi can be found at various retailers nationwide, as well as your favorite online retailer. So be sure to check that out. Also, have you ever wondered when you're at the grocery store and you buy that box of fruit roll-ups for the kids, maybe for their lunchbox, and you never really see fruit on the front anymore? I mean, as a kid, I remember always seeing fruit, you know, bountiful grapes and ripe apples and, you know, pineapples and the whole thing. Well, apparently that's changed, and there's a reason for it. Fruit roll-ups, of course, were a huge part of our childhood, and remember cracking open our lunch bags and finding that colorful pack of rolled-up sugar. Have you ever wondered why the snack actually never had fruit on the packaging? The lawsuit was decided in 2012, challenged General Mills to the claim that their item was made with real fruit, since flavors like strawberry, naturally flavored fruit roll-ups, contain no actual strawberries. Instead, the fruit-flavored snack boasts pure pear puree concentrate, corn syrup, dried corn syrup, sugar, partially hydrogenated cottonseed oil, and about 2% or less of artificial or natural ingredients. According to presiding judges, U.S. District Court Judge Samuel Conti, reasonable consumers might be misled by the snack's packaging and probably wouldn't read the fine print. Because of the suit, the new labels will not depict any fruit that aren't actually in the snack. For example, a strawberry-flavored fruit roll-up made from pear puree would not be able to show any strawberries, which I think it's fair. You know, consumers like to believe what they see on the box, and unfortunately, without reading the label, you wouldn't really know. Next time you're perusing through the snack aisle, take note of the different flavors of fruit roll-ups and look at the fruit they have on the box. Kind of interesting, a little game you could play with the kids. Where's the fruit? Also, Yoplait, I mentioned this earlier in the week, Yoplait bringing back custard yogurt in the big tubs. Be sure to check that out at your local retailer. You know, I'm not a big fan of custard, but I know a lot of you people out there in the listening audience around the world are. So check it out. Yoplait, you know, a good brand. Been around for a while. Dippin' Dots. This is something else, because when I go to the movie theater, I get these Dippin' Dots. Well, apparently they're originally meant to be cow feed. Yeah. Dippin' Dots are all over the place, from sporting arenas to amusement parks to movie theaters. The origins of these frozen treats are pretty bizarre, as they were not even meant to be ice cream. Dippin' Dots were invented in 1988 by microbiologist Kurt Jones, who was originally trying to figure out a way to feed cows more efficiently. One of Jones's experiments involved freezing cow feed at 350 degrees below zero, turning the cow food into little pellets. Taking that same concept, Jones froze ice cream with liquid nitrogen, which turned them into little Dippin' Dots beads we've all become familiar with. These dots' freezing temperature is so cold that grocery store freezers can't even store them. That's why we only see them at special locations. So you have to have a special freezer for the Dippin' Dots. After creating the dots, Jones found that natural heat within the mouth melted the ice cream pellets, making their consumption a little bit more pleasing. The dots caught on. The feed, well, not so much. So we can thank cows and Dr. Jones for Dippin' Dots. All right, thank you, Dr. Jones. And interestingly enough, the Michelin star, if you're familiar with food ratings, the Michelin star is a top-tier kind of award that restaurants win when they are of the highest caliber, the highest class. And apparently a humble burger joint was accidentally awarded a Michelin star. Typically, you're awarded a Michelin star because your restaurant is top quality, has amazing service, and serves out-of-this-world revolutionary food. Other times, you're awarded a Michelin star because the Michelin guide accidentally confuses you with another restaurant. This is true. This is what happened to Le Bouche et Aurel in Bourges, France. Again, that name is Le Bouche et Aurel in Bourges, France, which was awarded a Michelin star based on the interactive map released by the Michelin guide earlier this month. However, according to the New York Times, the Michelin star was actually meant for a restaurant with the exact same name, but over 100 miles away in Beautivier. So apparently this mix-up got this burger joint awarded the Michelin star. The differences between the two restaurants could not be more stark. The Bourges location is a small, lunch-only bistro that offers burgers, pommes frites, a buffet, and specializes in sausage and lentils, all priced at less than $13.50. The Beautivier's Michelin star located has lobster, turbot, and foie gras regularly on the menu, and its prices can range from 20 to 60 euros. Despite all the confusion, Le Boucher Aurel in Boucherville's will be keeping its Michelin star, and the mix-up has been since fixed. However, the Bourges location did benefit from all the media hype, and as a result, the owners even has an invite to come eat at the Michelin star restaurant of the same name. So interesting. So I guess the owner of the burger joint gets to eat over at the Michelin star winning restaurant with the same name. So he's like a special invite. So very cool. Kind of an interesting story. I guess you can't always believe what you read in the Michelin guide. And also, this is an interesting one. I've tried to attest to this to my wife over the years. Early birds make healthier food choices than night owls. Researchers looked at data from nearly 2,000 randomly chosen people to determine if their circadian or biological clock rhythm affected what they ate and at what time. Clear differences in both energy and macronutrients between the two chronotypes abound, with morning people making healthier choices throughout the day. Evening types ate less protein overall and ate more sucrose in the morning. In the evening, they ate more sucrose, fat, and saturated fatty acids. Yeah, so that means a lot of fried food, a lot of junk food, hamburgers. Yep, that's the truth. Listen, I'm an early bird. I know all about this. I'll tell you all about this. My wife is a night owl, and this is true. What I'm reading here is true. McDonald's, speaking of junk food, McDonald's actually serves bone-in ribs in the Czech Republic. This is an interesting story. Every year, McDonald's brings back the McRib, of course, a very popular pork patty slathered in barbecue sauce and served between two pieces of bread with some pickles and onions. While the sandwich itself is shaped like a rack of traditional ribs, it's still missing those delicious bones barbecue lovers can't help but gnaw on, probably because of the potential of choking hazards, of course, in lawsuits. That's not so much a concern in other countries, however. Brand Eating reports that McDonald's locations in the Czech Republic have begun serving bone-in ribs at select restaurants. The ribs, served in pieces of three, coincide with the launch of the fast food chain's new Big Tasty Bacon and Big Barbecue Bacon sandwiches and will be available at participating McDonald's locations in the Czech Republic. You can enjoy the ribs with a choice of dipping sauces like sweet and sour, mustard, barbecue, and sweet chili. And yeah, kind of interesting. McDonald's bone-in ribs. So if you're in the Czech Republic, be sure to check it out. Wait, did I just say that? Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up here on the What's Cooking Today show. I'm Eric Hines. We'll be back right after this on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
The smartest way for you to get the lowest prices on your plane tickets, domestic or international, is to call SmartFares, first or last, but you've got to call us before you book your plane tickets. Fly anywhere in the world, fly anywhere in the U.S., and SmartFares can save you up to 75% on your plane tickets. We have the lowest airline ticket prices on over 500 airlines, and you've got a great 12-hour free cancellation window. Plus, with our live agent help, you can always get fast help and fast answers. So on your next trip, maybe today, maybe tomorrow, how about right now? Pick up your phone and call SmartFares. Plus, save up to 75% on your plane reservation. So call right now. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644.
This is Larry Minetti for Herpanicin, the acne medication that really works from the inside out. If you suffer from skin problems, Herpanicin is the most unique and effective formula on the market. It cleans your skin from the inside out and gets rid of all kinds of acne and blemishes on your back, neck, and your face. It works so well, you can look and feel like a movie star. Herpanicin, a natural supplement created by Dr. Wayne Diamond. You take a pill, and that's it. I've been on these supplements, and they really work, folks. Don't be afraid to look in the mirror ever again. Get Herpanicin today. Call 888-467-4200. That's 888-467-4200. Herpanicin, it really works. 888-467-4200. Tell them Larry Minetti told you to call and look and feel like $1 million with Herpanicin. Call 888-467-4200.
This is a national healthcare alert from the Health Hotline. If you have severe knee or back pain and you have Medicare or private insurance, we have great news. Finally, there's a way to reduce your pain without surgery or taking medications. Call us today and learn how you can qualify to get a pain-relieving knee or back brace at little or no cost to you. We'll even ship your brace for free. If you have excruciating knee or back pain and you have Medicare or private insurance, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving, nearly invisible knee or back brace at little or no cost to you. I've used one. They're comfortable and they work, and we guarantee your happiness. So call right now and get yours. I promise, we're here to take your call. Thank you.
800-290-0759. 800-290-0759. 800-290-0759. That's 800-290-0759.
Welcome back, everybody. The What's Cookin' Today show. I'm Eric Hines, filling in for Mr. Michael Horn. Coming up soon, Miss Susan Zirinsky, the executive producer of 48 Hours. And we're going to talk about all this latest project called Stalked. It's going to be broadcasting Saturday, February 25th, this weekend. So for the weekend edition listeners, be sure to check it out. Very interesting stuff. We'll find out all the details, the juicy details here coming up soon. Apparently Little Caesars, now I know a lot of you you family folks out there, even you single guys or single women and bachelors and college kids, Little Caesars can become easily a part of your regular diet routine, of course, with their $5 special pizzas and all that stuff. You know, you get the quick and easy takeout, you pull up, you pay $5 and get a large cheese pizza. Well, apparently they're coming out with a new one. This one's called the Smokehouse Pizza. And it's slow-cooked smoked meats and pizza mixed together in this thing. It's a large, hand-tossed, round pizza and covered with a blend of mozzarella and Munster cheeses, topped with beef brisket, pulled pork, applewood smoked bacon, and barbecue sauce. To drive the barbecue theme home, To drive the barbecue theme home, the crust is sprinkled with smokehouse seasoning, brisket, and pulled pork. All this is being new to the chain. I don't know how appetizing this sounds. It doesn't really. I'm sorry, guys. This just sounds kind of weird. The brisket, which comes from Midwest beef, is brined with spices and then pit smoked with hickory wood for 8 to 10 hours. Now, if this thing was if we were buying this at like a delicious gourmet restaurant, I might be having a different opinion. But you know, I've eaten at Little Caesars before. I can't imagine they'd pull this off. You know, nothing against the employees and nothing against what they do well, because they do the cheese pizzas pretty well and they got the pepperoni, but. This sounds like it's a lot of technology going on. A little nervous. The pulled pork is cooked in rotisserie-style pit smokers for 10 to 12 hours. I doubt they have a pit smoker at these locations, too, so it's probably a bag of beef. While already available at some locations, Little Caesars' new Smokehouse Pizza launches February 27th. So that would be Monday, the 27th of 2017. You can find it for a limited time at participating locations for $9. And it is available hot and ready, so you just pull up and buy this thing. Stomach ache to go here from 4 to 8 p.m. at select locations. And you could order regularly outside those hours. If the concept sounds somewhat familiar, the pizza was spot tested last year. So some of you people actually already tried this. And I don't know. What do you think? You can go to the crntalk.com website and let us know what you thought about it. Post on our Facebook page as well, crntalk.com. The Facebook page / What's Cooking Today. Chipotle. If you guys have ever been to Chipotle, I've been to Chipotle quite a few times. And one of the things about Chipotle is probably the most aggravating thing is the insane amount of the line, first of all, and the wait times. I mean, a lot of times you're waiting quite some time. If you only get an hour for lunch and you go to Chipotle, you might spend a good half of that lunch actually waiting in line. Apparently, Chipotle is trying to fix that problem. They just completed the rollout of what they're calling smarter pickup times. It's technology that's going to end up in all locations that offer digital ordering with the intent of creating shorter and more accurate pickup times for online orders. According to the company, during extensive testing of the new system, wait times for digital orders was reduced by up to 50%, and they were able to process more digital orders overall without disrupting service for customers who ordered on-site. Yeah, nearly every Chipotle has an extra make line in the back where orders can be prepared. So interesting, I did not know that. So they do have some guys working back behind the scenes there that are doing this stuff. Smarter pickup times also lets you know more accurately how long your order will take based on the current volume of customers. It also allows you to schedule orders ahead of time. I know Starbucks has been doing this for a while, and it does seem to work pretty well. Many times I'd be in line at a Starbucks, and I'd see somebody just kind of sneak in, kind of bypass everybody and just grab their drink off this back counter and then leave. And I always wondered, hey, did they just steal a drink? You know, what's going on here? But apparently, no, it's legitimately, they bought that drink through the app. So apparently that's what Chipotle is doing. They're using this app method to decrease wait times, which is good. You know, again, you don't want to spend half your lunch waiting in line at Chipotle and smelling all the good food, and then, you know, you have no time to eat it. And apparently there's some cardiovascular benefits of drinking beer. There's quite a few people. When we get back from the break and after we talk with Susan Zirinsky, I'm going to touch on this because I have quite a few buddies have been telling me all the health benefits of drinking beer, yet they couldn't name one. So I'm going to actually help them out a little bit. I'm going to read all. There's quite a long list here. Looks like, oh my gosh, at least 11 different things that that my drunken beer buddies can, if their short-term memories can hold on to this stuff. Definitely an arsenal for when they do mention that beer is good for you. They can use this list. So we get back from the break after talking with Susan. We will talk about this, the surprising health benefits of drinking beer. I'll give you a little hint. Let's just say dandruff's on here. So we'll find out all about it and more. Coming up next segment, guys, Susan Zirinsky, the executive producer of the riveting show 48 Hours. We're going to be talking about this latest project she's working on called Stocked. And I think I've been stalking Susan Zirinsky. Well, I'll ask her if I qualify. We'll be back right after this.
This is the Mungle on Movies. I'm Matt Mungle. The Oscars are this Sunday, and predicting the Best Picture winner has never been harder. Odds would say La La Land should win, since it has won Best Picture from nearly every major award group. It has 14 Oscar nominations this year, tying a record with Titanic, and seems unstoppable. Manchester by the Sea will not win, despite the Casey Affleck performance, and Fences is too dialogue-heavy. I loved La La Land, but I have to admit that a win by Hidden Figures would be a win for us all. Visit MungleShow.com or follow me on Twitter at The Mungle.
When you've been married for 45 years, you begin to
finish each other's sentences.
Like how Kmart is now
a preferred Medicare Part D pharmacy with
copays as low as a dollar, which means we save lots of money. So I can finally build that
woman cave in the basement, Loretta's lair.
Wait, what?
Oh, you heard me.
Head to Kmart Pharmacy today for Medicare Part D copays as low as a dollar. Kmart Pharmacy accepts most Medicare Part D plans and is preferred in many. Visit any Kmart Pharmacy for details or go to KmartPharmacy.com to find a location nearest you.
Kaanapali Beach Hotel, Maui's Hawaiian Hotel.
Located in the heart of Maui's premier resort, Kaanapali Beach Hotel is officially recognized as Hawaii's most Hawaiian hotel and the number one best value in Hawaii. With a range of accommodations and affordable dining options, this is the ideal setting to turn Hawaiian dreams into lifelong memories. Live Hawaiian entertainment every evening, free year-round children's programs, weekly arts and crafts fairs, welcome breakfast, and departure kukui'lei ceremonies add to the value. Swim in the whale-shaped pool, indulge in the fabulous spa and hotel salon. Enjoy Hawaiian hospitality at its best at the Kaanapali Beach Hotel. Call 800-262-8450 or go to kbhmaui.com. That's kbhmaui.com. Aloha.
Kaanapali Beach Hotel, Maui's Hawaiian Hotel.
Hey guys, Ryan the Rhino DeSico here for my friends at Liberty HealthShare. If your healthcare has become a burden and you're worried about being stuck for another year, listen up, because you do have options. Liberty HealthShare could be the solution to your problem. Open enrollment is here, and this could be your chance to free yourself from insurance. Take this opportunity and join Liberty HealthShare. You can finally be in control and have freedom when it comes to your healthcare. Liberty HealthShare offers an entirely open network, which means you choose your own doctors and you choose your own hospitals. Liberty HealthShare offers freedom from insurance, meaning there are no related tax penalties. To find out how you can easily make the change, call Liberty HealthShare today at 855 585 4237 or visit their website at libertyhealthshare.org. That's libertyhealthshare.org. Do it today.
Come to Angelo's and Vinci's Restaurante in Fullerton, California for our sizzling party savings. Book your wedding event or reception, your birthday bash, or a special event of any kind and celebrate at Angelo's and Vinci's. Come to Angelo's and Vinci's and celebrate in one of our many festive banquet rooms. It's an incredible fun event you'll never forget. Food, music, and lots of fun. Call for the details and don't forget our daily lunch and dinners, plus our Sunday champagne brunch. Just $14.95. Minestrone soup, sausage and peppers, pastas, chicken dishes, salads, scones and muffins, plus so much more. A chocolate fondue fountain, zamplies, cannolis, fresh fruit, champagne, and Junior will be waiting to make the omelet of your choice from our omelet bar. Angelo's and Vinci's has been voted on the Orange County Hot List as one of the top five Italian restaurants for the past 6 years. And don't forget our award-winning pizzas. Thin or thick, they're yummy. All at Angelo's and Vinci's Restaurante at 550 North Harbor Boulevard in Fullerton, California. Call 714-879-4022. 714-879-4022.
Welcome back, everybody, to the What's Cookin' Today show. I'm Eric Hines. And Susan Zirinsky, she's the exec producer over at 48 Hours. And I got to tell you, 48 Hours is one of those shows that, you know, you're kind of doing stuff around the house and, you know, somebody's watching. Yeah, usually it's my wife. She'll be watching something on TV and I just kind of catch a glimpse of maybe, you know, so next thing I know, I'm locked. I'm like, I can't leave the room. I can't leave the living room and go back to the kitchen and finish my my dinner that I'm making. Something ends up getting burnt, you know, all this stuff, and chaos reigns supreme in my house, all because of this riveting show, 48 Hours. And right now we have Susan Zirinsky on the line to tell us all about the next episode. Boy, Susan, I got to tell you, Stalked, is that what it's all about?
Well, we do it a little bit of a different show. Polly Perrette, the CBS actress from NCIS, and I had been talking about the issue of stalking over the summer. And she really felt that this is an issue that has not been dealt with in the effective way. There aren't effective laws. And she has now taken this on as a cause. And it's not just a cause that has no relevance. She herself has been stalked for over a decade.
Oh, my gosh.
And the laws are very ineffective. And then we had Christina Grimmie, the singer who was gunned down by a stalker she didn't even know she had. And Polly Perrette says this is a wake-up call. While she didn't know she had a stalker, the Internet is the new gateway.
Yes, it is.
And yeah. So stalking is not just for celebrities, as Polly Perrette points out. It affects people in every form, in every job, in every city in the country. And as I said, the digital age has made it so interesting. So we take a look at both, at Polly Perrette takes us on this journey of what's happening. She was actually told when she went to the police about her stalker that if she had stayed and let him break her arms, then they could have acted and done something. But without any violence, they could do nothing. So she's actually she's working with Congress. She kind of has this band of women who have been stalked that she's trying to help. And we, in fact, do a kind of resource thing at the end of the show of, you know, what can you do if you're stalking? The main thing, stalking's laws have to change. They're
absolutely
ineffective. You can't wait until somebody has been killed. It's too late. Mental illness is a part of it. One of the stories we profile is a woman. She's a casting agent. She was stalked by somebody for, she is, 6 years. He wants to rape her. He wants to love her. He wants to be his roommate. This is the same guy who in 2010 was arrested and jailed for stalking Ivanka Trump. And that takes on a whole new meaning now, obviously.
Yeah. Absolutely. Well, this is shocking. And of course, you know, nowadays, especially with Facebook stalkers, it's almost, I hate to say it, you know, with the way the Internet is, it's almost like you said, a gateway. It's almost encouraged, you know, make all these friends, send them private messages. You know, it's really this kind of dangerous gateway for these people that do have a mental illness.
Well, you know, there's two kinds. There's, you know, some people have had former relationships with people and it goes south and they can't accept the breakup. The other are people with mental illness. The young man, Justin Masler, whose parents are really trying to help him. And this was a guy who went to Phillips Exeter but was diagnosed as a schizophrenic. And, you know, who knows if somebody's going to be violent? Yeah. You know, Polly Perrette says she's afraid to open her door. And her stalker, while he has never threatened her harm, you know, you don't know how something can turn. You just don't know.
Well, there's definitely a violation of privacy. There's a violation of safety. You know, people don't want to have somebody hanging around their house or their workplace or following them around to, you know, on their routines. And when you notice this type of behavior, I mean, the way the laws are set up now, is there anything that somebody can do?
Well, right now, you know, it has to be the threat of violence. There was a story about Gwyneth Paltrow's stalker who had been jailed many years ago. 17 years he has been harassing her, but the jury found that it wasn't a threat. He was sending these passionate love letters to the lawyer, and so he got off. But, you know, you live in terror that something can change. And Polly Perrette's point is, look, you have to strengthen certain laws on stalking. What constitutes a misdemeanor? When is somebody in danger? It can't just be after the fact when somebody's broken your arms. You have to be anticipatory. And so she is working, not, you know, and it is just not a celebrity-only issue.
No, it's
so
not.
She's turning. She wants new internet laws. She wants things classified as potential to be violent, and therefore restraining orders. One woman told us a story that her ex-boyfriend got a restraining order, and it was for, I think, 150 feet from her house. He couldn't go anywhere near it. So he parked his car for 7 weeks, 155 feet from her house, and lived there in his car. And she had a child, you know, so it's not like ISIS, but if you have a good portion of the population that's terrified to open a door, to go on Facebook, to do anything, fearing for their lives, the audio tapes that we have of the threats of this issue is pretty incredible. And we actually went in search of the stalker that has been harassing the casting agent. Her name is Lauren Clare. And she is the one that has the stalker who used to be Ivanka Trump, you know, jailed.
Yeah.
And you know what? His brother was in New York, and he recently was in New York. You know where he was? He was three blocks from Trump Tower.
Oh, my gosh.
But we actually find him, and we do a Facebook interview, and we talk to his mom. This is the other issue in stalking. If a person is found to be mentally ill, what are the rules of committing somebody against their will? These are the things that have to change, that have to change in order to have there be a cause and effect of stalking.
Well, this topic is so poignant, and it's very important. And for all our listeners and viewers out there, this Saturday, the February 25th, check out 48 Hours. The episode is Stalked. And you guys, it sounds like you really got in depth.
Polly Perrette will really be inspiring to you. And we also give tips on what to do if it's happening and resources. So we really think we're doing a public service here.
I agree with you, Susan.
While also being a great, intriguing story.
Absolutely. Hopefully I'm not cooking dinner at the time. Otherwise, it's going to burn again, because this happens every time 48 Hours comes on. I'm telling you. Susan Zirinsky, thank you so much for joining us today and really serving us this public service message. This is great.
Thanks. It's a wild show, and Polly Perrette is just passionate about the issue, and I'm really grateful for her participation.
Absolutely. I'm definitely fueled by it as well. And guys, if you do find yourself in these situations, be sure to let people know about it until we get these laws fixed. Let people know that there's a problem. Tell your family, tell your friends, so they can keep an eye out for you. And of course, definitely watch Stalked. It's going to be broadcasting this weekend, Saturday, February 25th, 9 to 11 p.m. Eastern, 48 Hours. Be sure to check it out. We'll be back right after this.
Oh, we've got to figure out a way to save energy, babe. Our heating bills are crazy.
See this?
Whoa, what's that? A new remote?
It is. Hmm. Budget Blinds was here this morning and installed these motorized shades in the kitchen. Come here, watch.
So I just sit here, they open, they close. This is really very cool.
Yeah, Budget Blinds comes in and measures, then they install everything. Oh, you didn't have to lift a finger, right?
Hey, I like that almost as much as the remote, but we were talking about saving energy.
Yes, right. See, the shades are also on a timer.
A timer?
You program the timer to open open them in the morning and let the sun in, then close in the evening to keep in the warmth.
Maybe we should do the rest of the house.
What a great idea, honey.
Right now, during Budget Blinds Luxury Within Reach event, motorized window coverings are more affordable than ever. The more you buy, the more you save, with savings up to $2,000. Hurry and call 855-BUDGET-BLINDS now, before this offer ends, or go online to budgetblinds.com. Don't miss out. Call 855-BUDGET-BLINDS now. Offer good on select products at participating independently owned and operated franchises. Restrictions may apply. Ask for details.
For the getaway of your dreams, come to Hawaii's Playground, Ka'anapali Beach Resort, on the fun side of Maui, where the world comes to play. Find your spot on Ka'anapali Beach with 3 miles of white sand, 12 resort properties, 2 golf courses, and 2 shopping centers. Enjoy the playground of Hawaii's ancient royalty. Ka'anapali Beach Resort is Hawaii's original master planned destination resort and home of the Hawaii Food and Wine Festival. With views of 2 neighboring islands, you can breathe in the land's natural beauty from your favorite resort or golf fairway. Come experience Ka'anapali's own special brand of Hawaiian hospitality with world-class dining, relaxing resorts, water sports, and activities of every kind. For romantic, family, and great friend getaways, discover the options of Ka'anapali Beach Resort, where the world comes to play. Plan your getaway today. Visit KaanapaliResort.com. That's KaanapaliResort.com.
Welcome back, everybody, to What's Cooking Today show. I am Eric Hines. And interestingly enough, you know, we all have that buddy who likes to pound down the cans of beer. And some of these guys, they'll tell you, oh, drinking beer is good for you. And, you know, we all kind of laugh it off and, you know. Well, apparently they might not be all that incorrect. It turns out that there's been a recent study done. And some of the benefits, the surprising health benefits of drinking beer. Number one, it promotes cardiovascular health. Beer improves heart function in many ways, maybe not liver function. But first, the drink can lower your chances of having a heart attack by 40 to 60%. I wonder if that's while you're drinking the beer, because I know some of my buddies are probably never going to have heart attacks ever in their life because of this. Beer also contains vitamin B6, which is known to reduce the compilation of this stuff called homocysteine, a known exaggerator of heart disease. Beer also thins the blood and aids in the prevention of blood clots and lowers inflammation. Many of the studies involving beer's effects on the cardiovascular system were run at the Fondazione di Ricerca in Icura in Italy. Don't ask me to say that again. An Italian research facility. Number two, it improves your kidney health. If you're a guy, apparently the number of beers you drink has a direct impact on your chances for developing kidney stones. This is seriously wild, according to this commentator. According to a group of scientists in Finland, each beer can reduce the risk of kidney stones up to 40%. When asked why this could be the case, there are a few hypotheses, but no clear answers. They say it could be the increased trips to the bathroom or the fact the hops from the beer have an effect on the speed of the release of calcium in the body. But whatever it is, we'll you know what? I'm kind of thinking I should need to drink a beer. Jeez, it's good to know. Also reduces the risk of cataracts. Researchers in Canada carried out experiments that led to the conclusion that one beer per day, especially if it's a darker beer, can boost your body's production of antioxidants in a way that could reduce your risk of developing cataracts or even stop them from forming in general. Here's where it gets bad. Apparently, if you have 3 or more drinks per day, the effect is actually the opposite, meaning your chance of forming cataracts is more likely. So one a day, one, if you can do it, one beer a day, dark beer, will lower your chance of getting cataracts. Also prevents diabetes, or diabetes, as my grandfather used to say. In 2011, a Harvard-conducted study showed the effects of moderate beer consumption and its correlation to type 2 diabetes. That's, of course, adult diabetes, related to the fact that your body no longer responds to insulin. The study showed that drinking up to 2 beers per day can reduce your risk for the disease by 25%. This occurs because the alcohol in beer helps your body regulate your insulin production, which is one of the main concerns of diabetes. All right, well, there you go. Prevents type 2 diabetes. Number 5, contributes toward post-workout hydration. Okay, now I don't know about this. I'm a big workout guy. Let's see what they say here. Apparently, beer is just as effective, if not more effective, than water at hydrating you after a big workout. This study was executed in Spain, where researchers had their subjects exercise until their body reached the control temperature. Then half of the subjects drank water, and the other half were lucky enough to be treated to a nice cold brewski. Shockingly enough, the people who had the beer were more hydrated than the others. To be honest, it was a slim margin, but we'll take what we can get. You know, I got to say, though, all things aside, you know, beer is also a diuretic, which means that it actually causes your body to release water as well. So I think that initially, this is my, now I'm not a doctor. Don't quote me on this, but I would pose this hypothesis that if beer is in fact a diuretic causing water to evacuate from your body, maybe initially after drinking the beer, you'd be hydrated. But I think the people that drink the water are probably long-term maybe more hydrated than beer drinkers. We'll have to find out. We'll have to do some more research on this one. I might have to lean on the Lipson Institute for wine studies to see if they have any information on this later in the week. Issue number six, it helps develop anti-cancer properties. Beer can aid the body in exhibiting anti-cancer properties, and we have a little antioxidant named xanthohumol to thank. Xanthohumol. This compound is found in hops, which are an essential ingredient for beer making, and has been known to take cancer-causing enzymes head-on, specifically the ones that can lead to prostate cancer in men and breast cancer in women. So I guess the idea, the compound found in hops, the xanthohumol, it works as a great antioxidant and helps reduce the risk of prostate cancer in men and breast cancer in women. Okay. Well, you know, again, we'll see about that. Boosts your memory. Okay. Now we're getting far-fetched here. You would think the opposite. Yeah, I kind of do. This commentator is saying that we think the opposite. I agree with him. But beer actually improves your memory. As a matter of fact, those who drink beer are 23% less likely to develop certain memory-related illnesses like dementia and Alzheimer's. Okay, now see, recently I heard another study, guys, that said that married people are less likely to get Alzheimer's disease. So is this saying that we need to be married and drink beer all the time? This is strange. I think I know people like that. Over the years, it has been revealed that one of the possible causes of Alzheimer's is an increased amount of aluminum in the body. Beer contains silicon, which scientists believe aid in the prevention of increased aluminum levels, therefore lowering your chances of developing Alzheimer's. Okay. Improves bone density. According to a study supervised by Tufts University in 2009, moderate beer drinkers have an average of up to 4.5% greater bone density than those who don't indulge in a daily brew. This also has to do with the silicon content in beer, which is an important part of healthy bones. Apparently, it makes you like Wolverine. You have these adamantium bones covered in silicon if you drink a lot of beer. Okay, this is getting really far-fetched. Aids in a healthy digestive system. Beer contains a healthy amount of fiber, which of course is an important aspect of digestive processes, the pancreatic enzymes, gastrin, gastric acid, and wait for it, cholecystokinin. Okay, whatever. So it aids in healthy digestive system. Also acts as a cold remedy. This one I can't attest to. Drinking a warm beer can serve as a cold remedy. No one likes a warm beer, but it'll get rid of your sniffles, and it is worth a try. And apparently it can treat dandruff. If you have dandruff, rinse your hair with beer a few times a week. You won't smell good, but you won't have dandruff either. There we go. Guys, stick around. More great stuff. Steve, the movie guy, coming up right after the break. We'll be back on the What's Cooking Today show.
Announcing a new handmade glass collection from Crystal Light Bohemia in the Czech Republic, established in 1794. The tradition of the factory remains, making handmade Bohemian glass with a family heritage and dedication for the finest craftsmanship, creating Czech glassware, the finest glassware in the world. Now, Crystal Light Bohemia brings this new and traditional glassware to the United States, featuring our world-renowned crystal products at reasonable prices. Crystal Light Bohemia also announces our new technology, titanium crystal glass, an abrasion and chip-resistant, shatter-resistant, crystal-clear, brilliant shine, and fire-polished crystal glassware like no other. Smooth to the touch, this lead-free crystal glassware is dishwasher-safe, stronger, and durable, yet so delicate to the eye. And it's in demand worldwide. Find out more and order your glassware today at crystallite.org. CrystalLite.org.
Let me take just a moment or two, if I may, and talk about a great place to eat. That's right, for you folks anywhere in the eastern San Fernando Valley, drop into Bob's Big Boys. That's right, in Sun Valley at 8274 Sunland Boulevard. Now, everybody remembers the name Bob. They're getting bigger and bigger every day. Little old Bob carrying the hamburger in his checkered overalls is the same Bob that you remember from back through the years. And of course, if you want to go in for a great lunch, Remember their classic burger, the original double-deck hamburger combination. Delicious 100% pure ground beef in two patties with American cheese, lettuce, and our famous Big Boy special sauce. The name is Bob, and I think when you go in, you'll say, by golly, I'm sure glad that I found this restaurant because it's good for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. They've got all kinds of things, and all you have to do is remember. Bob's Big Boy in Sun Valley at 8274 Sunland Boulevard. It's a great place to eat.
Turn down that radio!
If this sounds familiar, you know it's time to address your hearing loss. But custom hearing aids can cost as much as $5,000 each and are not covered by Medicare. The good news is MD Hearing Aid offers medical-grade, FDA-registered hearing aids for savings of up to 90% over traditional hearing aids. MD Hearing Aid was founded by a Chicago surgeon determined to develop a hearing aid that was technologically advanced, simple to use, and most of all, affordable. Call 1-800-511-8384. You'll speak with a trained MD hearing aid professional who will match you with the best hearing aid for your needs. Over 100,000 satisfied customers have already made the call. Call right now for our exclusive 45-day risk-free trial and get free shipping and a year's worth of free batteries, a $50 value. But you have to call right now. Call MD Hearing Aid at 1-800-511-8384. That's 1-800-511-8384.
And now, with the weekend box office in review, it's our own Steve Evans. Steve, the movie guy.
Hey.
Hey, Steve.
The Lego Batman movie, number one again last weekend. That thing's made over $100 million so far.
Wow.
We have 50 Shades Darker. That was number two. That's made over $90 million. The Great Wall, that's not doing quite what they had hoped in this country. Only about 18.5 was number three. However, don't feel bad because it's made over $200 million in China. I guess that's where the Great Wall happens to be.
Yeah.
John Wick, Chapter 2. That was number four. And Fist Fight rounding out the top five. Well, let me tell you, a lot of people are talking about this movie called Get Out. It's directed by Jordan Peele, who's one half of the comedy team Key and Peele. You may recognize that.
Oh, yeah, he's
name.
Hilarious, that guy.
Yeah, but this is not a comedy. This is a horror film. It's called Get Out. 100% of the critics are recommending this thing on Rotten Tomatoes.
Wow.
Now, this is about a young African-American man visiting his Caucasian girlfriend's mysterious family estate. Now, at first, Chris, the African-American played by Daniel Kaluuya, he reads the family's overly accommodating behavior. It's kind of a nervous attempt to deal with their daughter's interracial relationship. But as the weekend progresses, a series of increasingly disturbing discoveries lead him to a truth that he could have never imagined. Once again, 100% of the critics are recommending this. Also appearing is Allison Williams, co-starring in this movie, who is Brian Williams' daughter. Might want to check it out. Then we have a movie called Collide. This is kind of like Fast and Furious with a great cast in a great setting. This is about an American backpacker getting involved with a ring of drug smugglers, and just as their driver, though he winds up on the run from his former employers across the Autobahn in Cologne. Now, you have a great cast here. You have Nicholas Holt as that young backpacker, also starring Felicity Jones as his girlfriend, and the great Anthony Hopkins, and Ben Kingsley as well. Only 38% are recommending, but the trailer looks really cool. Check it out. It's called Collide. And then Rock Dog. This is an animated film.
Oh.
It's done by Ash Brannon, who was the director for Toy Story 2. It's not getting a real big push. I'm not really sure why. It looks like a terrific animated film. Only 50% of the critics are recommending. This is about a radio falling from the sky into the hands of a wide-eyed Tibetan mastiff. He leaves home to fulfill his dream of becoming a musician, setting into motion a series of completely unexpected events. Now, listen to the voice talent in this. We have Luke Wilson, Eddie Izzard, J.K. Simmons, Lewis Black, Kenan Thompson, Jorge Garcia, Sam Elliott, Matt Dillon, all in this movie called Rock Dog. Check out the trailer, an animated film, PG, so the whole family can go along. That's out there this weekend. All right, here's what I think is going to happen. We're going to have Get Out. That should be the number one movie, about $27 million, they're saying. The Lego Batman movie will fall to number 2, about 19.5, followed by The Great Wall, 50 Shades Darker, and John Wick Chapter 2 should round out the top 5. Let's not forget, this is Academy Award weekend. This is Oscar weekend, the big night, of course, coming up on Sunday night. Who do you think is going to win Best Picture?
Oh, man, that's such a tough one. Steve, I know we're going to elaborate on this topic for the weekend edition of the PM show later. I'm kind of stuck. That's a real tough call.
I would think La La Land. I've loved that movie from the time that I first saw the trailer. It's a feel-good film, and it's about the business of making movies. How can you go wrong? Nominated for 14 nominations, I think it's going to be a big night for that film.
It could
we'll
be a clincher.
We'll talk about it later this afternoon.
Absolutely.
That's what's happening at the box office. You can check it all out at the website. Have a great Oscar weekend.
Thank you, Steve Arino. All right, guys, we're going to do the weekend box office. Actually, the Academy Awards in review, Oscars in review, coming up later this afternoon on the PM show. Be sure to check us out. Steve, the movie guy. And, of course, if you missed any portion of the show, go to crntalk.com. crntalk.com to download archives of all your favorite shows, including this one. Just click on the What's Cookin' link and download the show right to your desktop, right to your digital device. For Michael Horn, Eric Hines, Steve, the movie guy, and for all of you out there in the listening audience, eat well, everybody.
CRN Digital Talk Radio prides itself on being the station of every situation. And you can listen to us on nearly any platform and device. Download to your iPhone, Android, and BlackBerry episodes of What's Cookin'. And take Master Sommelier Michael Jordan with you to the wine shop so he can help you pick out that perfect bottle of wine. Stream episodes of the Sonoma Wine Report through our CRN app. TuneIn Radio, Nobex, Stitcher, Ootunes, or AHA Radio, and start planning that unforgettable weekend in the wine country. They're in your corner on iHeartRadio, iTunes, and many other apps. And of course, you can always listen live through your local cable TV provider, as well as on our website at crntalk.com. For more information on where to listen to these great shows, along with many others, log on to crntalk.com and create your own listening experience today.
The radio channels. The radio channels.
News this hour from townhall.com. I'm Rich Thomason.
We are a nation that put and will put its own citizens first.
President Trump sounding familiar themes during an address to the Conservative Political Action Conference outside Washington. Mr. Trump calling the news media dishonest, assuring his audience that we're going to build that wall, and vowing to deport criminals in the country illegally.
We're getting bad people out of this country, people that shouldn't be, whether it's drugs or murder or other things. We're getting bad ones out. Those are the ones they go first, and I said it from day one. Basically, all I've done is keep my promise.
Mr. Trump, the first sitting.